snowboard video, we'll give you a drill to help you to be more dynamic in your snowboarding. So what that means is that I want to actually move a little bit more throughout the whole time I'm riding. So I've had some drills where I talk about having rhythm and adding to dynamic riding by turning with rhythm. But also, I want to kind of build on that, is that the whole time I'm riding, I'll have a little bit of a beat so that I'm just moving a little bit. My knees are nice and bent and soft, my hips, my ankles. And that way, when I'm out on the snow, I can absorb any little variable that comes with you. Because sometimes you're in a powder field and all of a sudden there's maybe an ice chunk or a rock or something, something that throws you off balance. And if you're able to kind of be nice and bounce and soft in your body, you're gonna be able to absorb those little variations in the snow. So we're gonna go out and try to just move. So a good thing to do is to get some type of music. I really love riding to music. I love doing a lot of things to music. It helps you just flow. And that's what flowing freeride is about, is rhythm and being in that state of flow. I know a lot of people talk about this in psychology, having that. Time slows down, where athletes talk about being in the zone, where that man's on fire, like basketball, for example. These basketball players, when they're in the zone, it's like Steph Curry, he shoots a three from almost half court because he's on fire and it just goes in, swish, nothing but net. That's what I'm talking about. When we're out here riding, I want you to feel that flow and feel that rhythm. So I want you to like have your brain to almost turn off, and you just done it so much that you're in that zone and you're in a good state of flow. So we're gonna go out and bounce to a rhythm. We're gonna get our either speaker or headphone, and we're gonna put that into our ear, and we don't want to put it into both if you do, or have a speaker that you can hear that comes in. Some people don't like doing that. I prefer doing either earbud in or some type of headphone, and riding to the beat the whole time. So that's the drill. To that rhythm and try to get into that state of flow where it's just reaction. You can grab anything, you're just really in rhythm. So that way, if you're practicing at that state, you can get to be where more of these professional athletes have talked about when they're doing something so many times, like baseball athletes. They are getting a ball that's throwing like 100 miles an hour at them. And they're able to actually hit that. It's amazing that I'm talking about time kind of slowing down because you're in that state of flow. So this drill, we're gonna go out, listen to music, and as we're riding, we wanna be bouncing the whole time to that kind of rhythm so we're in flow. And look at other videos I've talked about, like for example, the one up in the right corner, click there, that talks about rhythm. So when you're out riding with music, you want to make sure that you have one ear available. So take out one of your earbuds so you don't have both of them in. That way you can hear what's going on around you, because you don't want to be deaf to the environment around here. Because there's going to be people that come up on you 2 inches away from you. I don't know why they do it, but you want to be aware of that. So when you are out here riding with music, take one of your earbuds out so that you can hear with one of your ears what's going on around you. See you out on the slopes.
You can sign up for the full course to gain access to all of our snowboard lessons, study guides, textbooks, glossary, tests, and direct feedback from your coach. Learn to snowboard online with Flowing Freeride. subscribe, comment, and like.